Hi students, welcome to today's English class. Today we are going to discuss a very simple topic in grammar. This is the first topic in your English textbook, English Made Easy, prescribed by Osmania University for first year, first sem, BA, BCom and BSc students. As you all know, I am Roopna Ravindran, Assistant Professor of English, Government Degree College, Chevarlal, in Rangareddy district of Telangana state. So let us go on to the next slide where we have the description of noun, definition of noun. Noun is a name of persons, place, things, emotions, ideas, feelings, etc. So examples of nouns are women, Suresh, furniture, dog, happiness, love, and so on. Okay, so these nouns appear as subjects as well as objects, or subject and object complement in sentences. Let us look at the sentences and identify how nouns appear as subjects first. Okay, every sentence must have a subject, and subject will always be a noun. Okay, most probably the subject will be noun. Subject can also be pronoun. Okay, but let us consider the situations where the subjects are noun. The subject of a sentence is a person, place or thing that is doing or being the verb in the sentence. Let us take the example given here, that is, Maria is happy. Who is the subject in this sentence? Yes, correct. Maria is the subject of the sentence and corresponding verb is. Okay. Then nouns as objects. Nouns can also be objects of a verb in a sentence. An object can either be a direct object or an indirect object. Okay, so usually the objects are nouns or pronouns. So let us look at the objects are nouns or pronouns. Let us look at the examples in which we have nouns as objects. Look at the sentence, give the books to her. Here you have books as object. It is a direct object and her is the indirect object. Her is pronoun, books noun. Okay, clear? Noun as subject and object complements. Another type of noun use is called a subject complement. In this example, the noun teacher is used as a subject complement. Let us read that sentence so that we'll understand what I have said. Mary is a teacher. So in this sentence, Mary is the subject and we are telling something, we are complimenting something about Mary. That is why it is a subject complement. Teacher is a subject complement. Again, it is a common noun. Subject complements normally follow linking verbs like to be, become or seen. A related usage of noun is also called an object complement. I now pronounce you husband and wife. When the ceremony of marriage happened, the priest will say that you are now husband and wife. So here, husband and wife are nouns and they are used as object complement because husband and wife is adding something to you. Direct object is you there and the object complement is husband and wife. So I hope you are clear now. So nouns can be subject, nouns can be object, nouns can be subject complement, nouns can be object complement as well. I hope you are clear. Let us go to different types of nouns in the coming slides. But before that, let us do some simple exercises. You have been learning this topic since your childhood. So, it is just like a revision at the beginning of this semester. Okay? Brushing up whatever we have studied so far. And we will have sentences according to your current standard. Fill in the blanks with correct nouns for the following exercise. Use each noun only one at a time. First one, I don't have much dash, just two small bags. Which one will be the correct noun here? Look at the box over there. You have chairs, job, experience, information, hair, luggage, progress, furniture, permission, works. Yeah, the correct answer is luggage. Second one, they are going to tell you all you want to know. They are going to give you a lot of dash. Which one will be the correct answer? Yes, they are going to give you a lot of information. Third one, there is room for everybody to sit down. There are lot of dash. There are lot of, yes, it is the first option, that is chairs. Fourth one, we have no dash, not even a bed or a table. So chairs already gone. So what is the next furniture? Here the answer is furniture. We have no furniture. What does Ellen look like? He's got long beard and a very short dash. Hair. Yes, the correct answer is hair. Sixth sentence, Carla's English is very bad. She must make dash. She must make progress. It is the correct answer. Seventh one, George is unemployed. He is looking for a job. If you want to leave work early, you have to ask for good permission. Ninth one, I don't think Anne will get the job. She hasn't got enough experience. Tenth one, Shakespeare's dash are wonderful. Shakespeare's works are wonderful. I've given the answers here. So if you are not clear about anything, you can just refer here. Different types of nouns. So these are the different kinds of nouns that we have in our language. First one is common nouns, proper nouns, countable nouns, uncountable nouns, concrete nouns, abstract nouns, compound and collective nouns. So these are the different kinds of nouns that we have in our language. So let us discuss the first type of noun, that is common nouns. Common nouns are used to name persons, animals, places or things in general. So we are going to talk about these in general, that is you talk about man, you talk about woman, you talk about children, about country, about place, everything in general, but you are not mentioning the name of the man, the name of a woman, name of a child, okay, name of a place and so on. So that is the difference. So here we are only referring to nouns in general, and that is why it is called common noun. Look at these examples. Have you seen my dog? Dog is in bold. It is a common noun. I am not specifying the name of the dog. The dog's name might be Robert or Jimmy. We cannot say. Okay. So those are not common nouns. Common noun is dog. The books are on your desk. Here books, common noun. Desk again is common noun. So I am not naming the book. I am not naming the desk. So they are, I am talking about them in general. That is why they are called common nouns. Let us go to the next slide. Proper nouns. This is quite contrary to that of common nouns, as you all know. Common nouns, we are describing something in general. We are talking about something in general. But in proper noun, we are talking about a specific person, place or thing. Example, Raju. When you say man, it is a common noun. When you say Raju, it is a proper noun. When you say place, it is a common noun. When you say Hyderabad, it is a proper noun. When you say country, it is common noun. But when you say India, it is proper noun. So I hope it is pretty clear for you. Proper nouns always start with a capital letter. At the beginning of a proper noun, you have to write capital letter. Let me introduce you to Mary. M is in capital letter. The capital of Italy is Rome. Italy is a place. Rome is again another place. So you are putting the first letter of those proper nouns in capital letters. He is the chairman of the British Broadcasting Corporation. You might have heard about BBC, that is British Broadcasting Corporation. So that is a proper noun. I was born in November. If it is months, it is common noun. But here I am mentioning the name of a particular month, November. Okay, so it is a proper noun. Identify whether the word in bold is proper or common noun. So we are given 10 sentences. In each of the sentence, you will find at least one word in bold. You have to decide whether that particular word is a common noun or proper noun. Let us look at the first sentence. We met at McDonald's at noon. The word McDonald's is a dash noun. It is a name of a shop. Okay. So what do you say? It's a name of a restaurant kind of thing. So it is a proper noun. There are 12 months in a year. The word months is a dash noun. Months is a common noun. You are correct. If you are naming the month, like earlier we have said, November is a proper noun, but here we are generalizing all the months. Okay, we are not mentioning about any specific month. We are talking about 12 months. So that is a common noun. My favorite movie is Grease with John Travolta. The word Grease is a dash noun. It is the name of a film. So it is a proper noun. Lisa works as a programmer at Microsoft. The word Microsoft is a dash noun. Microsoft is the name of an IT company. So it is definitely a proper noun. I live in a small town in England. The word town is a dash noun. What is it? Is it a proper noun or a common noun? Yes, it is a common noun. I am not mentioning the name of the town here. So, it is a common noun. Place, city, town, village, country, all these are common nouns. My cousin lives in the USA. Cousin is a relation. I am not talking about the name of the cousin. So, it is a common noun. I want to visit Bangalore when I finish school. Tell me, what is it? Yes, it is definitely a common noun. School, college, all are common nouns. Call me when you arrive at the Rajiv Gandhi International Airport. Rajiv Gandhi International Airport is a, yes, proper noun. I have a checkup with Dr. Prashant on Friday. It is a day. I'm not generally talking about the week or days. So it is a proper noun. Specifically, I'm talking about Friday. 10th sentence. We saw whales in Indian Ocean. Are there whales in Indian Ocean? Don't know. Whales? Yes. Is a common noun. Next is countable noun. Some nouns can be counted 1, 2, 3, etc. We can count them as 3 liters, 4 liters, okay, 2 centimeters, like that, okay. So, they have singular and plural. Those kinds of nouns have singular and plural. Examples are students, bench, benches, dog, dogs, district, districts, and so on, okay. I have only $5. So here dollars, a countable noun. The earth was formed 4.6 billion years ago. It is again a countable noun. There are lots of people, but we don't have a car. People, we can count the number of people gathered there. So it is a countable noun. Cars, we can count how many cars are passing by on the road. So it is again a countable noun. Let us move on to uncountable nouns. Uncountable nouns are those which we cannot count. For example, water, milk, sugar, sky, etc. Unlimited. Okay, but we can make certain uncountable nouns countable by adding certain words before it. For example, milk is uncountable, but we can make it countable by adding 2 glasses, 1 liter, and so on. Then it becomes countable. Am I clear? Okay, so rice is uncountable. We cannot count 1, 2, 3 rice, okay? But when we add this number 1 kg of rice, it becomes countable. Again, we can count. Water is uncountable, but when we add 2 bottles of water or 1 liter of water, then it becomes a countable noun. We never use uncountable nouns with a definite article. We won't say a water, okay? Uncountable nouns are always singular. Uncountable nouns are always used in singular. That we have to notice. Examples: water, happiness, cheese, etc. Have you got some money? Air conditions use a lot of electricity. So we use these kinds of words. Some, a lot of, few, any, all these words we can use before those kinds of uncountable nouns. But we don't use the indefinite article a or an before these kinds of uncountable nouns. Now, you have another exercise given here. In this exercise, you have to identify whether the words in bold are countable or uncountable nouns. There are at least 20 Italian restaurants in Little Italy. We can count the restaurants, number of restaurants. So it is a countable noun. Second one, there is no water in the pond. Water is uncountable noun. We have already discussed this. I need to find information about Pulitzer Prize winners. Information is uncountable. Megan took a lot of photographs when she went to the Grand Canyon. Megan went to a vacation, went for a holiday trip to the Grand Canyon. So there she took a lot of photographs. So it is countable. Your book is on the kitchen table. Book, table, both are countable. You seem to have a high level of intelligence. Intelligence is uncountable noun. How many candles are on that birthday cake? Candles countable, birthday cake countable. You have several paintings to study in the art appreciation class. Both are countable nouns. Paintings countable, class countable. Please take good care of your equipment. Equipment is again countable. You can count how many equipments are there. 1, 2, 3. There is a big brown dog, only one, a big brown dog. So it is countable. Then you have concrete nouns and abstract nouns. Concrete nouns can be touched, smelled, seen, and tasted. Concrete nouns, as we have already said, can be touched, smelled, seen, and tasted. Examples given here are dog, tree, apples, etc. So look at these examples. Have you met James Bond? James Bond is a person. We can go and touch James Bond. So it's a concrete noun. Pour the water down the drain. Again, it is a concrete noun. Water, we can touch water, we can drink water. Okay, so it is a concrete noun. Now, what are abstract nouns? Abstract nouns are nouns that you cannot touch, see, smell, or taste. For example, happiness, love, freedom, sadness, respect, kindness, all these kinds of things cannot be touched, cannot be sensed. Okay? So, the examples are, he has great strength, cannot be sensed in the sense with our five senses. Okay? But we can understand if it is the reaction of our close a friend or any close relative. Examples, he has great strength. So strength is an example of abstract noun. Who killed President Kennedy is a real mystery. Mystery is an abstract noun. Sometimes it takes courage to tell the truth. So courage and truth are both abstract nouns. Their lives were full of sadness. Sadness, we have already mentioned, is an abstract noun. So here you have an exercise. You have around 10 sentences where certain words are given in bold and underlined. So we have to identify whether those underlined words are abstract nouns or concrete nouns. So let us read the first sentence. Despite the bad news, mother still had hope that the house would be built. So here the underlined word is hope. Can we go and touch hope? No. So it is an abstract noun. Father had a new idea about how to raise money for the project. Idea, again, it cannot be touched, smelled, or tasted. So it is an abstract noun. He usually scratched his head when thinking about something important. So head, we can go and give a kick or a slap on the head if we want to. So it is a concrete noun. He thought the townspeople might be interested in a lottery. Lottery is again a concrete noun. If enough people wanted the prize, the lottery could create great excitement. Excitement is an abstract noun. Father decided to put up his horse for the lottery prize. Horse is a concrete noun. Many people in the town believe that luck was on their side. Luck is an abstract noun. They bought scores of tickets at $10 a piece. We can hold the tickets. It can be touched. So it is a concrete noun. When mother saw the final sale totals, she felt great joy. Happiness, joy, sadness, all are abstract nouns. We had enough money to build the house, which became a source of pride for us. House is a concrete noun and pride is an abstract noun. So I am pretty sure that this concept is very clear for you. Don't have any confusion at all. Here you have compound nouns. Compound nouns means two or more words create a noun. So it can be a noun plus noun. It can be an adjective plus noun also. It can be a verb plus noun also. Sometimes we can't say a preposition may also be added along with the noun. Okay. So we cannot say that combination, but compound nouns are combination of two words and it functions as a noun. Each compound noun acts as a single unit and can be modified by adjectives or other nouns. Examples are classroom. Class plus room becomes classroom, which is a compound noun. Rainfall, rain plus fall. It can be three words also. You look, sun, in, law. Again, three words. In the middle, you have a preposition. Credit card, vice president, team member, etc. All these are compound nouns. Compound nouns have three different forms. Space between words, they might be hyphenated or they may be solid connected words. So bus stop has a space in between. Mother-in-law has hyphen in between. Football is closed or it is solid, doesn't have any space in between. Okay. Can we use the swimming pool? Swimming pool is a compound noun. They stop work at sunset. Sunset is a compound noun. Don't forget the checkout. Don't forget that the checkout is at 12 noon. Checkout is a hyphenated word. It is a compound noun. So we have examples here. We need to identify the compound noun in each of the following sentences. There are 10 sentences. So let us read the first sentence. My boyfriend and I are going to the movies tonight. Boyfriend is a compound noun. It is a combination of boy plus friend. The policeman rushed to the scene of the crime. Police plus man. So policeman is a compound noun. Next, a similar one. A fireman was severely injured in the blazing fire. Fire plus man. So it is a compound noun. We have had a lot of flooding because of the constant rainfall of late. Rainfall is a compound noun. Get your haircut today, please. Haircut is a compound noun. It is a combination of two words. Hair is a noun and cut is a verb. The onlookers cheered the football team. So, football is a compound noun. The teacher had written his name on the blackboard before class. What is a compound noun here? Yes, it is definitely blackboard. Please brush your teeth with toothpaste. Tooth plus paste. It's a compound noun, toothpaste. We are going to the cafe to have breakfast. Breakfast is a compound noun. We got up very early to watch the sunrise. Sunrise, sunset, all are compound nouns. Clear? Now we'll move on to collective noun. Collective noun denotes a group of individuals. Examples may be team, gang, crew, family, etc. Okay. Collective nouns can be treated as singular or plural. So this rule is applicable when we consider the subject-verb agreement. When we consider the concord, we have to be mindful of these collective nouns. Most probably we use singular, but even if we use plural form of the verb, there is no problem. His family live in different countries. An average family consists of 4 people. The new company is the result of a merger. The board of directors will meet tomorrow. So all these are examples of collective nouns. In this slide, you have a lot of collective nouns which you have to learn. If it is a group of wolves, then you say that it is a pack of wolves. We don't use the word group of wolves, but we say a pack of wolves. A pack of Jews, that is also correct. When there are lots of Jews, then we say a pack of Jews. A herd of buffaloes, a group of buffaloes means a herd of buffaloes. If there are a lot of swans, then you say a ballet of swans. If there are a lot of snakes, then how do you say? A bed of snakes. Then an army of ants, an army of ants. Army is a collective noun. A flock of birds, flock is collective noun. A flock of sheep, here also flock is collective noun. So you have to use it according to the words given. Okay, it changes, but meaning of all these are more or less the same. Herd of deer. Earlier also we have used a herd of buffaloes. Here we have herd of buffaloes. A hive of bees. If there are a lot of bees, then you say It is a hive of bees. A litter of puppies. If there are a lot of puppies, you say litter. LITTER. If there are a lot of crows, if there is a group of crows, then you say a murder of crows. That doesn't mean the literal murder where you kill a person. Okay, here murder means a collective noun which means that it is a group of crows. A band of musician. Band is a collective noun. Band means group. A board of directors. You might have heard this. All these are common. Band of musicians, and then board of directors. A choir of singers. In church you will have choir. Choir of singers. A class of students. So group of students are called class. Crowd of people. If there are a lot of people, then you call it, obviously call it a crowd. If there are thieves, five thieves, then you call them a gang. Usually you call friends gang, but actually for thieves you have to use the word gang. Experts, a panel of experts. Players, a team of players. Very familiar one. Indian cricket team, Indian football team, so on. A troop of dancers. That also may be familiar for you. We use it naturally, dance troop. Okay, so troop is the collective noun here. A bouquet of flowers. That is also very commonly heard. A fleet of ships. If there are a lot of ships in the harbor, then you say there is a fleet of ships. Fleet means group of ships. A forest of trees. If there are a lot of trees, we call it a forest. There is no doubt about that. There are a lot of stars, then you call it a galaxy. Or you can say constellation. Both are correct. A pack of cards. Earlier we used a pack of wolves, pack of Jews. We can also use a pack of lies also. If you are a person who says lot of lies, then you say pack of lies. A pair of shoes. A range of mountains. A bundle of books. That we often use. A bundle of books. Here you have to complete the following sentences using appropriate collective nouns. So some of them might not be discussed earlier. So let us read these 10 sentences and let us try to fill it. Write it down. A dash of locust attacked a dash of cattle. Okay. A swarm. It is SWARM. Swarm of locusts. Swarm means group of locusts. Attacked a herd of cattle. Herd of buffaloes. Herd of deer. Herd of cattle. A dash of birds is always a beautiful sight. A group of birds means you say a flight of birds. They welcome the chief guest with a bouquet of flowers. As we drove down the countryside, we saw a herd of sheep grazing in the fields. The dash of thieves has been arrested by the police. Thieves, we use the word gang. The dash, that we have already discussed. Sixth sentence. There we saw a man carrying a dash of clothes on his head. What will be the collective noun there? A bundle of clothes. We see dobies and all carrying bundles of clothes. A dash of musicians was hired to perform at the party. A band of musicians. Eighth one. My friend has a fine dash of old stamps. This is very easy for you. What is the correct answer? What is the collective noun here? A collection of old stamps. Ninth one. A large dash gathered in the street. A large group of people means what do you say? Crowd. Yes, a large crowd gathered in the street. The hungry fox saw a dash of grapes. Group of so many grapes. Bunch of grapes hanging from the vine. So, 10th one is the hungry fox saw a dash of grapes hanging from the vine. Here you have the answers given, okay? And finally, you have a passage here. It is a simple passage. You have to read this passage and you have to write it in your notebook, underline the nouns, and then tell or you write on top of the nouns whether it is a proper noun, common noun, countable, uncountable, abstract, concrete, collective, or compound noun. So it is your responsibility to learn better. You have to write this whole paragraph in your notebook and then try to identify the different types of nouns in the passage. Let me read it so that you become a little familiar with the passage. In June, easily you can identify June is a proper noun, talking about the name of a month. Simon asked his mother. Simon is again a proper noun. Mother is a common noun. Okay. If she could buy him a dog. Dog is common noun. Simon has always wanted a dog named Charlie. And now that he was 14 years old, he thought that he was old enough to have his own pet. Simon's mother told him that if he babysat that his little brother Jack the whole summer and showed responsibility, then we would let him get a dog when the next school year started. They have provided one condition. If you babysat your little brother, then we will definitely buy you a dog. Every day since then, Simon woke up early every morning and went on his paper route. He then came home and babysat Jack until his mother came home from work in the evening. After the summer ended, Simon's mother was impressed with his dedication and decided to get him a dog. Simon wanted to adopt a dog from the shelter. So, Simon and his mother went together to look for a good dog. After looking at a few dogs, Simon decided to adopt a small Jack Russell Terrier. That is the name of that, breed of that. Simon finally fulfilled his wish of having a dog named Charlie. So most of the nouns that you have here are proper nouns and common nouns. So that's all for today regarding nouns. So read your textbook. You have textual exercises. I haven't discussed those exercises here. And now that you are pretty clear about nouns and different types of nouns, you can do that exercise on your own. Okay, it's not at all difficult. It will be very easy for you if you listen to this video thoroughly. That's all for today. Thank you guys. Thank you for listening. We'll meet with the next video. I have given references here. You can go to that websites and then check for more information. Thank you, students. Stay safe.